there are some more web security risks. A study or report says the top web security risks are identified. They are on the basis of their severity. First, SQL injection. Second, password breach. Third, data breach. Fourth, remote file inclusion. Fifth, code injection. Sixth, cross-site scripting. In short, we call it as XSS. Seventh, broken authentication and session management. 8. Insecure direct object references. 9. Cross-site request forgery, CSRF. 10. Security misconfiguration. 11. Insecure cryptographic storage. 12. Failure to restrict URL access. 13. Insufficient transport layer protection. And 14. Unvalidated redirects and page forwards. We'll see some of the significant ones one after the other. First one, injection flaws. Injection flaws particularly involve SQL injection. Injection flaws occur during the interpretation of a command or query where the data becomes untrusty. When the hacker injects, then there occurs an execution of unintended commands or unauthorized data access. As a result of successful injection, the hacker gains access to change or correct or delete users' data and also can exercise denial of access or a complete host takeover. The second one is XSS, cross-site scripting. XSS vulnerabilities target on embedded scripts of client execution page, which is a web browser. These flaws occur due to improper validation of data entered in an untrusted web browser application. The attackers can run the scripts on the victim's browser. Executed malicious scripts cause session cookie hijacking, website defacing, or sometimes it may even redirect the users to inappropriate websites. Third one, broken authentication and session management. For each valid session, there is a creation of session cookie. We know that. The session cookies contain sensitive data like the username, password, etc. These cookies are destructed once the session is ended by abrupt leave. This happens for most of us. For example, when we use a CypherCafe, if the user closes the session abruptly while running an important application, an attacker could browse a previous session of the victim and gain access to the sensitive information like profile information or credit card details, etc. A proper implementation of keys, session tokens, and cookies may prevent such compromises. The fourth one is insecure direct object references. When a developer uncovers a reference to an internal implementation of object, then there happens a creation of direct object reference. The implementation of objects may include files, directories, or database keys. The hackers identify and make changes to these object references due to misproper access control checks. As a result, the hackers gain access to the restricted data. Then comes the cross-site request forgery, CSRF. A CSRF refers to the process of forging a HTTP request when a victim is signed in on a vulnerable application. the attacker can send a fake link to the victim and he may force the user to enter into malicious website URL, resulting ultimately in the theft of users' private data. The next important one is security misconfigurations. Applications, frameworks, application server, web server, database server, an operating platform, all may require to be defined and deployed with proper security configuration. Otherwise, an attacker can gain access to authorized sensitive data, which is quite dangerous. Regular software updates are the ultimate solution and they are absolutely necessary. Otherwise, it will result in complete system compromise. Next is insecure cryptographic storage. In common cases, vulnerability exists due to the insecure storage of sensitive data, like your user credentials, personal profiles, health details, court processing information. These are some forms of sensitive data. They are actually stored in the application databases. When this data stored is storage is happening without encryption or hashing, it becomes vulnerable to attack. So such sensitive data must be encrypted or hashed. Next, failure to restrict URL access. Web applications often check the URL access rights before rendering protected links and buttons. Similarly, applications are also needed to check for access control whenever web pages are accessed. In most applications, the special rights to pages, locations, and resources are not made available to the unprivileged users. They are known as access control mechanisms, which we have previously discussed about it. An attacker, by intelligent guess, can access these privileged pages by invoking functions to view certain confidential information. The next important thing is insufficient transport layer protection. The sensitive information, once again, like our credit card credentials, user authentication details, the session tokens, all important data are transferred only through network layers. This information is exposed to untrusted users due to the absence of SSL, that is the secured socket layer. This takes place due to the usage of weak algorithms, expired or invalid certificates. Next, unvalidated redirects and page forwards. Sometimes the users are redirected or forwarded to inappropriate pages for intended purpose by some web applications. If there is no proper validation, it will definitely redirect or forward to other pages, and attackers ultimately make use of this opportunity to attack the victims by using phishing or malware to access the unauthorized pages.